Hello, good afternoon, folks. Welcome to the Spirited Art Studio, and I'm happy to be providing this in my kitchen for the last couple sessions here as during our summer months. And just starting here again, and I'm kind of waiting for maybe some of you to arrive and say hello. So in the meantime, I thought I would just explain a little bit about Spirited Art Studio, what it is, what it's about, and who can participate in it, and so on. And I just thought the easiest thing to do would be to just introduce it just as it is on our Robertson Wesley United Church website on the Spirited Arts Movement page. So just to let you know, you can go to rwuc.org. That is the website. And then you just click on it and scroll down and look for the Spirited Arts Movement and click on that. And that will take you to the Spirited Arts Movement page. And that is where you can find further piece information about the Spirited Arts Movement, the Art Studio, about each of us, the artistic directors in the Spirited Arts Movement, and our different programs that we have going on. So you'd be able to scroll down and see all of this. And then as you are interested in any of the programs, you can just click on those programs and register in them. So for example, this Spirited Art Studio is going to be continuing to happen on Monday evenings and Wednesday afternoons. We're going to continue with Facebook live stream on Monday evenings, and then we are going to try something different for Wednesday afternoons, which will be to provide online Zoom art studio sessions where we can all be together and see each other and share our art and have our voices and our just some more visibility and just have more of a connection with each other on that Zoom. So the Zoom, if you're not familiar with it yet, it's very user-friendly, and if you go onto this website and onto our Spirited Arts Movement page, you'll find more information about it. We're asking that if you are interested in being a part of the Wednesday afternoon Zoom sessions, that you please register. And you will be provided with a link. You'll be emailed, and the Zoom link will be provided to you, and you just simply click on the Zoom link. So that is what is happening this fall, and that's going to be starting the week of September 14th. So today and next week, we're going to be continuing with botanical sketching. That this is just sort of a mindful exercise, mindful creative art exercise. And so I'll be just kind of leading you through that kind of idea. And so we'll be doing that today and Monday and Wednesday. And then Labor Day, the Spirited Art Studio will be closed, even virtually. We will not be running the program as it is a holiday, and we will so we will start with the new fall program in the following week. Sorry, Labor Day is September 7th, and so we'll begin with fall programs on Monday evenings on September 14th, and with the live Zoom meetings. So there'll be art studio meetings together. Hello, Shao. Oh, I'm glad you find that the plans for the fall sound good. Thank you. So yeah, I think it's going to be fun. I think it'll be really, I'm really excited and looking forward to it, because I think it's going to be really great to see some familiar faces and hear familiar voices and share each of us share some of the art we've been doing over the summer and what we would like to do possibly together in the fall, and just to be together again, connecting and being creative is just going to be really great. And I'm also looking forward to, so Robertson Wesley Church itself will be reopening September 13th. That will be the first reopening church service. So the worship service will be that morning. And so that is going to be exciting. And so the reopening, stage one reopening of Robertson Wesley is on Sundays, and that is the worship services themselves. So that is the number one priority. And so that will be the beginning of the opening in stage one. So we can look forward to stage two and stage three when further opening of other programs will be start to become open and will be in place. So I'm proposing that in stage two, that the Spirited Art Studio will be open to the public once again, and I'm going to be writing a proposal for that. But in the meantime, and that may not happen until stage three, because there's so much to think about with all of the different programs, the different protocols and that need to be in place for the safety for everyone. And so basically, until we have the go-ahead to come back to Robertson Wesley in person and attend the Spirited Art Studio in studio in person, which is in the lower hall of Robertson Wesley. Until then, we will continue with this program, which is starting on September 14th in the fall. So that will be the Facebook live stream similar to this on the Monday nights, And then on the Wednesday afternoons will be the Zoom studio art session. So likely what I have planned for Monday evenings on the live stream can kind of prepare you so to be ready for the Wednesday afternoon Zoom sessions. And again, what you'll need to do to be a part of the Zoom session, so basically to be in an online classroom sort of studio setting, you will need to go online onto the Robertson Wesley United Church website and find the Spirited Arts Movement page, and then scroll down to find a link to register for the Spirited Arts Studio Zoom meetings. So this will be up on the website by the end of next week, likely. And I will just confirm that next week while I am just carrying through with the last few sessions of our summer on Facebook live stream sessions. And so with these last few sessions, I'm going to be carrying on with the idea of botanical sketching and using, today I'll be using pencil and pen and ink. This is a Faber-Castell archival quality fine tip point pen, which I really like to sketch with. I like it because of the permanence of it and just the quality of it, and it works well with both with felt pens and all dry media, pencil crayons, and as well as works really well with watercolor. And so watercolor is what I will be working with next week. So if you're interested in that, and I know that definitely some of you are very interested in watercolor. So I'm hoping if the weather's cooperating that I will work with watercolors en plein air, which means on location, outdoors, with everything, your watercolors and everything portable, so that you can take it with you and go sit outside. So I won't be going very far because I'll need to be staying within close enough to have a Wi-Fi connection for this Facebook link, but I will show all of the kind of tools that you would need to go for a hike, take your watercolors with you, all your materials with you, and go to maybe Horlock Park or any other recreation area that has trails that you could take. Just take your art materials with you and sit and paint and draw there. So that I think will be a fun couple of sessions next week. And then again, the week after is just going to be Labor Day weekend, and so Monday it will be closed that week. The studio will be closed for programming and for planning and for organizing and so on. And then September 14th is the beginning of our fall program in the Spirited Arts Studio. So I think I have said enough about all of that for now. I am just going to read to you what it says on our website about the Spirited Art Studio. So it is typically on Mondays at 7 and Wednesdays at 1:30 in the afternoon. It's a part of the Spirited Arts Movement. And the Spirited Arts Movement is committed to bringing people together and creating space for all ages to be inspired and to have their artistic selves unleashed. We believe that the world can be healed and transformed, and that justice can be served through self-expression. We express ourselves through visual arts, drama, writing, movement, voice, music, and digital arts. This is a movement and one that is ever changing and evolving, and definitely one you want to be a part of. So the Spirited Arts Movement has two directors, myself, Laura Foster, and I am the artistic healing director, and Brooke Leifso, and Brooke is the justice artistic director. And so together we have workshops going on and different kinds of programming. Mine is more around the therapeutic ways that art can help us, and Brooke's workshops are about justice. And so please check out Brooke's work as well, and more up-to-date information will be again on the website soon for all fall programs and workshops. So the Spirited Art Studio is a place for people to explore art and connect with each other in an informal creative environment. Each time we have various art media and processes to explore. People are welcome to drop in anytime. And so you do not need to begin in the fall and be committed to coming nightly or weekly throughout the year. You can just show up and be at the studio when you can make it. However, we do ask or recommend that you register. And in the case of right now, while we will be having Zoom sessions, registration will be necessary to be a part of those sessions. So regular attendance is not required, but registration via email is recommended. And again, please refer to the website, rwuc.org, Spirited Arts Movement page, for more information about registration. So the studio's purpose is to bring people together to enjoy art, to be in community. And some people like to work on their own ongoing projects, and other people like to have prompts and directives. So we try to accommodate for both of those, both things, so that people who have their projects, can go ahead with their projects and just be together in community, while others can be introduced to new ideas and new directions. So I hope that gives you a little bit of an idea of what's going to be happening here starting in the fall. So just to carry on with our summer program, I have mentioned and have been showing you a little bit about this idea of botanical sketching, about taking pieces of plants and florals from your gardens and studying them closely, studying the leaves and the florals and their structures, the way they way the leaves branch off the main stem, and the way the little or maybe larger florals are structured, and how they are clustered together or in different varieties of whole many, many different kinds of florals and trees and so on. We can just kind of have a very mindful focus on what they look like, and then take that and just sort of have a quiet focus and draw what we see as we look carefully at each of the different portions of the plant. So I have this. This is from a tree in my front yard, and this is from a vine in my backyard, and this is just a little tiny twig off a cedar in my backyard. So I just want to assure you it's from my own yard, and I'm not clipping branches off of any trees, not harming anything in any public property, and I hope that I'm not hurting anything at all. And so I've been kind of thinking about what's been happening way down south, southern Texas and New Orleans, and just thinking about folks down there, and just with very, very prayerful, heartfelt concern with the hurricane that is going to be going through there in the next few hours, and I guess 24 hours, and I'm just hoping for the best outcome for all the folks down there. And I'm just thinking about how it's just difficult when we think about times like this, and we think about how people are vulnerable in these catastrophic kinds of storms, and what kind of weather will prevail, and what kind of harm that might come of people. And yeah, it's hard, especially if we know people in those areas. And so it's hard to know what to do, except to just to pray and just to hope for the best, and just Just stay calm and hope that things will be okay. So what can we do for ourselves during this time when we can be kind of overcome with worry, and then we think of the combined concern in this present time with the concern for over and above the weather of the hurricane, we think of the reality of the pandemic and how that is going to really further complicate everything and make things less safe for people. And so our heart goes out to them, and we just really hope for the best. And so one thing that I find that is helpful when I'm thinking about things that feel so out of control is just to take time to do a contemplative kind of mindful process that just can help us just take a break from our difficulties and concerns for a while, and just do something that is calming and that can just help us to relax. And so an exercise such as this sketching of botanical pieces of our gardens can just be one of these mindful processes that just kind of bring us into the present moment as we study the leaves, the foliage, the blossoms, the structure, and just really study them and think about how we can reproduce this sketch on a page. So I'm going to turn to a new page in my sketchbook. I find that these are moleskin journals with blank pages, and I find them that they are just really great. They're very portable. They are small. There are limited number of pages, so you feel like they are doable. You can get through a whole journal of sketches in a summer or in a month or even in a week, depending on how much time you have. And the pages also have a really nice texture for drawing and sketching. So I recommend those. But really, any kind of journal or sketchbook is perfectly fine, and you can probably find them at the Dollarama or any place where you happen to be grocery shopping even, or shopping for stationery supplies. There's a lot of different journals available. And even if you have just lined sketch or journals or notepads, they will be just fine as well. And so I also have, just regular HB pencil, and I find that those are great for sketching when you're planning to add further drawing, like pencil crayons or any other kinds of medium. It's just nice to have an HB regular pencil. A softer pencil isn't really necessary, and it may just smudge. And so, yeah, the hardness of a regular HB is just right. And then I again have the fine point permanent ink pen that I will probably sketch over top. And then I have this this bin sort of wood container of a whole collection of different kinds of wooden pencils. And so I'll be using those as well. And so I'm just going to get started. And I think out of these three types of varieties of plants, I think I'm just going to work with this one just for this afternoon. And so I'm just going to begin with just looking at how it's structured with the main stem and then each leaf branching off from it, and how it's the overall form, and then the detail of each leaf. And then later I will study how the colors are on the leaves, and see how I can try to reproduce that on my art journal page as well. So one thing I recommend when you're doing this, anytime you start, is just to begin with just a little bit of a breathing exercise, and just be conscious of your posture and get comfortable and relax your shoulders and sit up and just stretch up high, reaching your head up high towards the ceiling with your feet flat on the floor. And then just take some big breaths in and out. And just noticing your breath as you inhale and exhale. And just relaxing into your breathing and noticing your breath, and just focusing on your breath and what is happening in this present moment, how you're feeling, what sounds are in your room, the lighting, and just conscious of your present environment and being with your environment, and just removing yourself from your any thought processes that are going on, and just distancing yourself from those processes as you begin to become more present with and engaged with your breathing and the present moment. So I hope that was helpful, a little just reminder of just the beginning process of the mindful process and being engaged. And so the second thing I invite you to do is just to just have just sort of letting go of any judgment about your process or about your sketching, and just to have sort of a beginner's mindset, or just a very childlike mindset in the drawing process, that the outcome of the sketch doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what it's going to look like. And just be curious about the plant and about what it looks like, and just sort of getting familiar with it as your subject matter that you are going to study, and that you are going to sort of make a drawing, or even you could say a portrait of. So I'm going to now take my pencil and just begin to look closely at this branch of this vine that I have, and I'm just going to put on some music, and as I begin to draw it, I will once in a while I'll lift my page to the screen and just show you my sketch. So in the meantime, I am just going to put on some music because I find that music just helps me stay focused and engaged in the moment, and it just kind of adds to the ambiance of the creativity. So, this is just from Apple, it's Piano Chill. Hi, Joy. Thanks. I guess it kind of goes with my botanical sketches that I'm doing today. So thanks for noticing. And so this is my branch that I'm kind of working on. It's a branch from an ivy plant. And so this is my botanical sketch. And I'm just going to finish some of the inner line work of the leaves. One thing I was noticing, that the veins of the leaves lead out to the points of each. And so it's just a very subtle thing that is fun to notice. And these are kind of like the things that you begin to notice when you're working on a plant and studying it. When you're working with pencil, one thing that is nice to think about is just the pressure of the pencil line. As you can see, some of the lines are darker than the others, and it just adds interest to the drawing. So now I'm going to sketch the pen. So I think it really depends on what you're drawing and what kind of effect you want to achieve. So for example, on these other sketches, I did have ink as part of the drawing. I sketched with an ink pen over top of the pencil. But for this drawing, I think I'm just going to go straight to working with pencil. So just looking at the different variations of color on the leaf I just drew. So there's a variety of greens and a variety also of this sort of burgundy color that really adds to the leaves and makes them just a beautiful color. I think that they've changed to this color as the season is coming to an end, that all the leaves are just starting to change color. So I hope you can hear me above the audio, and if you have any troubles, just let me know. But I'm just going to, again, go into sort of a quiet time as I just get involved in the process. And I'll just, again, continue with the drawing. And once in a while, I'll just lift up the page and show you how the drawing is going. So I'm hoping that you can kind of see what I'm doing as I'm doing it, and you can see my pencil and so on. find that adding lots of variety of color just to emanate what I'm seeing just really adds to the drawing and adds to sort of the richness of it and of what I'm seeing. So I'm just going to continue with this. So this is what I've got so far as I've beginning to bring some color into the drawing. Hi Jane, glad to see you're here. I'm just gonna try pressing on this. This is what Facebook says to do. It says wave, so I waved. Don't know if anything happened. So I'll continue. It's good to always remember if you're bringing, if you're working with pencil crayons or even just pencils, to have a sharpener. Nice reds. going to do a little bit more online, and then I think I will just take it offline because I think all of you probably got the idea by now. So I'm just going to finish this bottom leaf, and then I'll show you what I have. If anybody would like to provide any kind of comments. Oh, there's Jane. Hello, good to see you. Oh, thank you, Jane. Thank you for saying so. So, yeah, I think I'm just gonna do a little bit more, and then I'm just gonna stop the music and just invite you to, and encourage you to just enjoy going outside and going for walks in nature, and bringing something with you just to draw on. And so you bring a water bottle, bring a regular pencil, maybe a pen, and maybe an eraser, just in case, but try not to use it. Try to use it as little as possible. And maybe just some colors that you think that you would like to use. So maybe just all of this and your journal itself would all fit nicely into a pencil case. And then just throw it in your backpack with a bottle of water and a snack, a lunch, and away you go onto a nice nature walk, and enjoy just a nice, lovely time outside while we can still enjoy these milder temperatures, and have some nice, mindful, calm, peaceful time, finding grounding and centering in nature. And just as we engage and focus in our creative process. So thank you, those of you who have taken some time out to join in today and say hello. And thank you to those of you who may tune in later and see what's happening. And look forward to seeing you also next week, when I'll be doing something similar. That's what I've done here, only I will be using watercolors and hopefully going outside and doing the work in plein air as I did already once this summer. And again, I wouldn't be going far, but I encourage you to do so, because you wouldn't need to have the Wi-Fi. And you wouldn't need to stay close enough to have to be doing this on live stream on Facebook. Although I encourage you to do that as well if you feel like you would like to be challenged and draw live on social media. We do have a private group page, Spirited Arts Movement. As a private art movement page, where you could share your work with us, and even share a video if you like, of doing some art and processing, just as I'm doing. And yeah, so I invite you to do that as well. So yeah, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you all as a possibility this fall with our program that we're going to do online on Zoom. So I look forward to seeing who might register and who may like to Zoom in. So look forward to seeing you. Hi, Lori, good to see you. And thank you again, everyone. Bye for now.